Okay, Steve says, you explained what happens if a storage drive fails, but what if the parity drive fails? Can this simply be replaced? Mm. And does it have to be replaced with a drive of the same size?
Yeah, refer back a couple of episodes ago. We did a feature learning how parity works in 60 seconds flat. And in that feature, you see how that actually functions. So, and that's part of why the parity drive has to be the largest drive in the array, because if it ever fails, it's got to be able to rebuild itself. So what happens there, just kind of answer your question. So your parity drive fails. Let's say that's your scenario, okay? So that's the drive that carries all the parity data. You take that drive out, you replace it with another drive that's, again, either the equal size or larger than the largest drive in the array. So in this scenario, because you've lost the parity drive, you've lost parity on your array, it then recreates parity on the new drive. So it basically builds a new parity drive out of all the data across all the other hard drives in the array.